In essence, Connect Designer is an HTML editor with most of the features you'd expect in such software. Adding HTML elements, images, and texts, applying styles using CSS, and creating a design that hopefully pleases the eye of the person who views the result. In this animation, we'll explore some of the main cool features that Connect Designer offers by creating an email template that's fully functional from scratch. So instead of showing you each button in the interface, we'll be using the most useful and common functionality, a bit of drag and drop, and maybe a bit of magic. So let's start by creating a new email template. We go in File, New, and select the email template before clicking Next. Here we'll give a name to the template. Let's call it OLSG Promo. We'll leave the subject as is because it will be modified dynamically. We then change the layout to a single column to fit our pre-existing design. Finally, we'll uncheck the header that we don't need and change the background to white. Instead of creating a data mapping configuration, we'll simulate what a PrintShop Mail client will be able to do, add a file data source directly from the menu. To do this, we go in File, Add Data, From File Data Source. The first step is to select the data source file, in this case, OL Sporting Goods Customers. A wizard then lets us set the encoding, followed by delimiter settings similar to the ones visible in the Data Mapper module. Since, as usual, settings are automatically detected for most CSV formats, we just need to click on Finish without changing anything. Now that we have our record set and our basic context, it's time to add some contents to our page. Most of the email is built using images, so we can start by importing the images as resources by dragging them directly into the Images resource folder. Before adding the images to the context, let's take care of the extra contents that we don't need from the default email template. We'll also add some personalized text and format it. As you can see, the text includes a field from the record. This is our first bit of variable data. And now we add the images. As you can see, this is already a pretty nice email, courtesy of our marketing department. But even better yet, with the use of simple script wizards, we can dynamically change the images to target our users. This is done in three steps. The first step is that we need some way to identify the image so that a script can refer to it. The best way to do this is to give a unique ID to the image. We'll call the first one OLSG Promo. The second step is to create a dynamic image script wizard and associate it with that ID. And finally, we set up the wizard. The wizards offer easy ways of using VDP, in this case for images. Here, we'll need to add the OLSG promo to the prefix, as this is how the image will be referred to. We then select the ePromo field because this is where the appropriate promo, ski or hockey, is located. When we click on OK, go in the preview, and browse to a record where the ePromo is ski, we can see that the image changes. Let's do the same for the bottom image. We'll give it the contest ID. Then make a dynamic image wizard in the same way we did for the other image. Here, small difference. The second image is a PNG, so we need to change the extension in the suffix box. At the bottom of our email, we have a footer with links to social media in an HTML snippet that's been given to us by the marketing department, along with the images needed to display it and the CSS style sheet that applies to it. Let's start by adding the resources to the template. The style sheet can be applied to the context simply by dragging it on top of the section. This automatically includes that style sheet when producing output. As for the snippet, we simply drag it on the page after our existing images, and everything just works. This is because the HTML snippet already points to the proper location for the images. Another thing that needs to be added is the promotional code on top of the bottom image. Because the email's size is always the same, we can simply add a positioned box on top of the white square, which needs to be done in the design view. And then we'll resize it. Type in our promo code, and then style it. Note that if our promo code was included in the record, we could simply have dragged it inside the position box. In our case, the code here will be static. Some of the images we just added also have links that are dynamic and lead to a landing page on the OL Sporting Good website. Now, adding a link is simple. We select the image and click on the Insert Hyperlink button in the toolbar. Now, if our URL was static, we could simply type it in here and we'd be done. But because the link is dynamic, let's just put a placeholder and click Finish. When we come back to the template, the link is already selected. We need to give it an ID, and it must be different from the image, so let's put in OLSG promo link. Here's a little cool tip. If you want to be able to select the link in the future, because it's not an element that really appears on the page, you can't directly select it. However, when you have an element selected, such as an image, you can see at the top that there is a breadcrumbs bar that displays the currently selected element and a few of its parents. You can then click on the link to see the attributes for that link again. There's currently no script wizard to create dynamic links, so instead of boring you with creating a script to dynamically change it, I've already prepared one and it will be visible in the resource section of this course. Let me do the same dynamic link for the contest button, which is actually just the same script. One very last detail. The email subject is also dynamic. Here, we thankfully have a wizard to help us out, the email subject script wizard. We can simply add it and configure it in a way that's similar to the image. Let's take this occasion to see that we can actually add more than one field in those wizards. So we'll use the suffix to separate the fields with text, and adding the first name, last name, and ePromo fields, we can create a nice personalized sentence right here in the wizard. So this is it. Now let's send some emails. Don't worry, we can send only a single email and return it to ourselves instead of trying to send 20 emails to non-existing addresses. To do this, we simply click on the Send Email button in the toolbar, enter our own email, and set the outgoing mail server, which can be provided by your IT department. The record range lets you define which record to send. By default, it's the first one only. Note that the function that lets you send the email back to yourself is the Send All to Sender. In production, you would normally uncheck this box and it would use the email from the customer directly. Now, if you click on Finish, you should receive a nice promotional email shortly.